members of the public and members of council staff to participate.
Today's demonstration, we were told, was a piece of theatre, but definitely no comedy, since that was the reserve of the Home Office with their insistence that a nuclear attack on Islington is survivable. Not so, says the left-wing council, and to make the point, the banner outside the town hall, which normally shows the borough's jobless total, was changed to reveal what the organisers say would be the nuclear death toll. And to reinforce the message, the mayor, the councillors and council officers and even members of the press were invited to drop dead on the town hall steps, while a loudspeaker above told us that this was no laughing matter. But surely the citizens of Islington are perfectly aware of the bomb and its implications without their elected representatives having to sprawl all over the pavement.
No, I don't think they are, and the particularly immoral thing that the present government is doing, it is encouraging people to believe it's possible to talk of surviving a nuclear attack. What the Islington Council is anxious to do is to see that ordinary people concentrate their energies on campaigning for nuclear disarmament, and we believe that we have a duty to the general public to see that everybody is aware of the realities of the problem.
After the resurrection, those that could be bothered were invited to tour the council's nuclear control centre, from which the borough will supposedly be run after the bombs dropped. And whereas visitors may have disagreed on the usefulness of it and other civil defence measures, everyone conceded they prefer not to be proved right or wrong. This is Stephen Chambers in Islington.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.